Okay, so welcome everyone to a series of videos that's going to look at the best places to eat when you're traveling on a gluten-free diet. So my first video is on Gdańsk in Poland, and I just want to say straight away the experience in Gdańsk was incredible. Really did not struggle to find lots of places offering gluten-free items. My girlfriend, who's in a lot of these clips, she eats gluten and she was very jealous of all of the gluten-free options, and these were often the best items on the menu. So without further ado, I'm just going to mention the first one and our most favourite, which was Balan's Coffee Specialty and Breakfast, which is located right in the heart of Gdańsk. And you can tell by my excitement here how happy I was to see that they did gluten-free bagels.
Gluten-free bagels.
So Balan's was a really cute little place, really good coffees, really nice atmosphere, and most important of all, they offered a range of different types of bagels, all on a gluten-free bagel. So we went with the New York bagel each, which was absolutely incredible, and it involved salmon and cottage cheese. It was so good that we ended up going there twice during the holiday. It was just amazing, to be honest. And they also do really nice coffees. So I got a flat white, that was really nice. And Hannah here got a matcha, which she thought was good, but not quite as good as the flat white. And here I am digging into the bagel. It was just, what can I say? 10 out of 10 Balan's bagels, gluten-free. Okay, so this next option is an incredible option for both lunches and teas or dinners, as it's called outside of the north of England. And it's called Ukralika, and it's a completely gluten-free restaurant. Like, every option is gluten-free. It's fantastic. There's so many choices, as you could see from the menu there before, like, you know, fish, seafood, vegetarian, meat, they did it all. And the atmosphere of the place was really nice. We made a special effort to go out to this place because you have to get the tram. You have to get the tram from a stop called Brama Wagina 01, which is definitely an absolute awful pronunciation of that word. And then you get it and you ride it, number 609, to Wojska Polsigiko, which is also an awful pronunciation. But I'm just going to put the direction of the route on the screen for you to work out for yourselves, because my Polish is probably worse than my English, I would say, being from Yorkshire, but yeah, not great. So the inside of this restaurant was all Alice in Wonderland themed. Really nice. We ordered a couple of coffees to start here. Gluten-free biscuits, of course. Very nice coffee. And then I went for the gluten-free burger, which is absolutely unreal. And it had aioli coming out of here. And these steakhouse chips were gorgeous. And Hannah got the gluten-free schnitzel with cabbage and potato, and I think she actually won this one in the battle of the options, because that cabbage and that schnitzel was beautiful. And you can see here, I wasn't expecting that she was going to give me any, but I had it recording and ended up with some, so got lucky there. Ukralika, definitely worth a visit. Okay, so this next recommendation is a cafe and coffee shop called Fu Cafe, which is one that I guess you want to be careful in pronouncing. And this place is actually quite close to Ukralika. So we had lunch there at the gluten-free place, and then we went over to this cafe for a couple of coffees and some cake. So they do multiple different gluten-free options.
Thank you. Cheers.
And if you are a vegan, then that's even better news, because it's completely vegan here. So very nice, very relaxed surroundings. It felt a little bit different to all the other places, because it felt like we were in more of a local spot here. So what we ordered was a chocolate brownie, and also like a blueberry chocolate tart, both absolutely unreal. And a couple of matchas as well, really, really nice. Wasn't expensive at all, so we've got the receipt here. I'm not sure what that works out to exactly, but I'll put that on screen as well as the directions. So yeah, Foo Cafe. Okay, so this next place, whilst being gluten-free, isn't actually a restaurant, it's a bar, but I would definitely recommend visiting. It's called Wisniewski, maybe that's how it's pronounced, and it's a cherry liqueur place. It's really cool, £3.20 for a glass of cherry liqueur, you can get it hot or cold. Lots of people just come in, grab a glass and go. Really nice atmosphere, definitely recommend it. Okay, so this next place was called Pomelo, and we really enjoyed it here. We actually went for an evening meal and for breakfast as well. It was better for the evening meal, and what I got here was herring, which was cold. It was really, really nice with potatoes, and Hannah got some fried dumplings, which she didn't say were the best, and I ordered better here, definitely. For main, we got the two gluten-free mains. So we got the duck breast here, and then Hannah actually got the carrots and sprouts. And what we did, and what I'd recommend you do, is half each meal and then combine the two of them together, because that was unreal together. So if you can't really be bothered getting the tram out to somewhere to get gluten-free cake and coffees, there is a place in the centre of Gdansk called Retro Cafe, and I'll just let Hannah explain her astonishment at the different types of coffee here.
It's like condensed milk, espresso, steamed milk, and milk foam. What are you getting? Is that right? There's so many different types of coffee. Are you seeing the brew bar?
And now here is what I ordered. So this was a chocolate cake covered in like caramel and peanuts, pistachio latte, which was incredible, and I've eaten it about 20 times already. And here's just a video of me struggling to get to grips with how to get ice cream off. And do we get the thumbs up? Yes, it gets the thumbs up of gluten-free approval. This was beautiful. Definitely go to Retro. Okay, so this place, like a lot of the places that did gluten-free, was a vegan place and vegetarian place, and this was gorgeous. This was a beetroot tartare with vegan cheese and pralines, and it's one that I'm definitely going to be making now that I'm back in the UK. And again, Hannah liked this, but she looked out and she thought that mine was a better starter. This was a tofu and date kofta curry with rice, really, really nice, and Hannah copied this. Finally, she thought she'd go with the gluten-free and get the best one. Really tasty, definitely recommend Manor 68. Now, no offence to this next place called Mott's Lava. And I was to and froing about putting this place on here, but I did put it on because it does offer gluten-free options, and I did like elements of it, but it was probably the place that we liked least out of all of Gdansk. But it still was really nice, and that speaks, I think, to the quality of the food there. So I would go there if you are, you know, starting to run out of options, maybe you just want to try something different. I suppose what is really good here is that they had a full allergen menu, like allergen guide of all of the different ingredients and things like that. And I did really well. Again, Hannah was jealous for both of my starter and my main. So for starter, I got these cabbage rolls in tomato sauce. They were nice, but, you know, nothing amazing. You know, it was very standard sort of food. However, and then Hannah got dumplings, which weren't the best dumplings that she's had, but they were okay. However, the main was actually quite nice. So I got pork cheeks here with beetroot and dumplings, and they're potato dumplings, so they're completely gluten-free. And I've been actually thinking about them a lot since then. Hannah got duck breast. She was very disappointed, but I would go. And now, last but certainly not least, is probably my most favourite place of all, and I can't believe I'm saying that about a Mexican place in Poland, but Pueblo in the centre of Gdansk did fantastic gluten-free options, and I'm just going to let the video do the rest of the speaking for us, to be honest. I've ordered the chicken and beef fajitas, which are gluten-free upon request, and I'm very excited. This is my excitement for this.
I'm jealous, I should have said it.
Yeah. And of course Hannah did happen to slip in a bit of some evil gluten at some point throughout the holiday, but was very happy about it. And so, just to summarise really, I did not struggle at all to eat on a gluten-free diet in Gdansk in Poland, and in fact there's just many different places all offering amazing food, really high quality of food, and all of the places that I've listed here and throughout this video are very clued up on gluten allergies and gluten and ingredients. So yeah, I've kind of listed them in the order of the places that I would go to and which ones we thought were the best. But, you know, try and work it out for yourself as well and see if there's anything that I missed off. If you'd like to, please just like this video and subscribe to this channel. I'll just do more videos as I go travelling and review different places to eat gluten-free. So, yeah, thanks for watching, everyone.